Welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I'm Amethyst Lutatari. We're headed towards this gun for hire. We're supposed to track someone down. Eventually gotta meet with Takamura. Find out. It's 8:37. He just said at night. Meters. Not in a dead end. What? You're showing off. The hell? It does a flip. You really can't. Oh my god. Why can't I actually turn in this thing? And I'm supposed to be up there, I think. Maybe not. This thing does not turn. Regina Jones.
V, got a rat problem on my block. Who doesn't, right? Thing is, these rats are human-sized. Look just like tiger claws, too. Ah. Biggest one is a certain Taki Kenmochi. So do your fixer a solid and neutralize her ass, will ya? Deets attached.
Okay. Geek type, gun for hire. Oh, is this the one I'm actually headed to? Taki Kenmochi, location residence building at Cortez and Kennedy Street. I got a place at this block in Kabuki. Not many know about it. Welcome to the club. And I prefer to keep it that way. Problem is, a certain tiger person and friends set up a pachinko operation right on my doorstep. Could mean trouble for me down the road. Let me guess, you're thinking it's better to hide in plain sight, right? Yeah, screw that. When, not if, the NCPD cracks down on those pachinko machines, I know they're gonna poke their ugly pig noses around in my backyard. Can't risk them seeing something they shouldn't. We can't sit in this. Head to the residential block, where a tiger by the name of Taki Kenmochi is running this pachinko show. Deal with her. Any other tigers in the area will get the message and peace out quick. Okay. Just left. Tracking. It's gotta be the same one. Yeah. Approach the pachinko machines. I'm guessing we're killing this person, not trying to reason with him. I mean, why else would it say gun for hire? What does the red thing mean? It's not on the map. I guess it's a person. A dangerous person. Hey! Motel hell.
Happening number five.
What? Beat her again?
Oh, she flatlined him. Shot him dead.
No way. You sure?
I in number six side. Told me everything.
I? I'll say anything. Come on.
I'm serious. Bullet went right through the wall. I saw the body with her own two eyes.
Guess your name's I?
How are you?
I know it's in there. I'm just going to look around a little bit. Kabayan Foods. I've never been over here. I guess I haven't been over most places. A damaged poker chip? Caliente. You okay over there?
What's up?
Wasabi. All foods merchandise. Hi. Cab tools. Candles. Oh, I like the music around here. Mind me, just picking up staplers and stuff. Oh, this is referring to this. Jack in. Oh, what am I doing? Oh, extracting euro dollars, okay. Oh, it's 1C, 1C. Hi. I thought you were someone I'd be talking to. Technical ability. Failed. Fail. I fail. That's what I do, I fail. Oh, is he gonna turn hostile? Let's find a different way. Safe and sound Night City gangs. We're gonna new that's called Hit. Oh, is that what we were given? Genki's family wrote to me. As they were preparing the body for the funeral, they found someone had torn out all his implants. Checked it out. Genki flatline and leaf shop. Looks like that piece of crap's got a little side thing going, selling off piece of our boys. Kill him. Alright. So I don't think we have this gangs thing. Hi there, it's your friendly neighborhood canine, Sergeant Dobbs. Okay, definitely not. Have read this one. This useful little guide you're holding contains essential information on the Night City's largest gangs, where you'll learn which districts to avoid, how to recognize gang members, and how to avoid dangerous situations. Animals. The animals aren't real animals. They're freaks of nature. Pumped to the gills with strength-enhancing hormones, they look more like piles of meat than people. Oh my god. They generally avoid cyberware, with the exception of cosmetic modifications that supposedly make them look more like, well, animals. They're extremely aggressive and don't need an excuse to start a brawl, but despite their name, the animals are not a territorial gang. You can find fierce, hostile packs of them throughout the city. Sixth Street Gang. From a distance, they could be easily mistaken for soldiers on leave. Military uniforms, combat boots, buzz cuts, shouting oorah every chance they get. But don't let appearances fool you. These are violent, dangerous thugs, ready to slit your throat without the slightest hesitation. You want to watch out for them, especially in Vista Del Rey. The Mox. Handsome girls, beautiful guys, but wait, it's a trap. They'll reel you in with their charm, and when you're least expecting it, bam. Your eddies are gone, or worse. The hole in a wall that passes for their headquarters is called Lizzie's Bar. Best seen from far away and never entered. Oh, please. Lizzie's Bar is pretty cool. Maelstrom. If you ever find yourself in Watson's industrial area, and it's better that you don't, watch out for the sinister faceplates. That's Maelstrom. To be part of a gang, you'll have to get your eyes and nose cut off and replaced with demonic, fiery red optics. Ouch. If they do that to themselves, who knows what they'll do to strangers. Better to leave that mystery unsolved. Tiger claws, we're familiar with them. Effervescent neon tattoos with Asian motifs, katanas and shurikens, racing bikes. These are some of the trademarks of the Tiger Claws gang, with a noticeable presence in Japantown. Ignore them and they shouldn't bother you, but do something to provoke them and it's sayonara, baby. Valentino's, Jackie's gang, his old gang, anyway. Golden grills, golden implants, golden crosses, and golden machetes say hola to the Valentinos. Despite the Catholic symbolism, they're not exactly love thy neighbor types. Those who get in their way usually end up chopped into pieces and tossed into the Del Coronado. Voodoo Boys. These predominantly Haitian gangers are based in Pacifica, but they'll hint their victims elsewhere, the net. The Voodoo Boys are the most skilled netrunners in the Night City underworld, but beware, that doesn't mean they're not dangerous in real space, too. Be sure to give them a wide berth, or you might just end up like one of their black roosters without a head. Okay, so to sum up the shard here, avoid all gangs. The end. Troublesome neighbors. I've got a gig updated? Oh. Oh, it's the same thing. Bio has grenade, huh? Oh, well, I can't go up there. So I guess I just start killing these people. You know, I've been wondering, I think... Oh, I thought I had some points or something to use. It doesn't tell you, like, how close you are to leveling up or anything. Right in the face. Oh, there's more. I see you. Look, you fell? She fell down. turn on? Oh, I'm playing it. I'm playing that. I'm like, what am I turning on? Well, that was fun. Nothing in there. So this was the one. Was that the one? It was her. Abrasion-resistant trickster dress shirt and vest. And a conversation between Taki Kenmochi and Kenji Sakura. Let me read that. Taki Kenmochi says, Hey, opportunity knocks, Chum. Kenji says, Taki says, Tony's out of biz. Mouth open, smiley face, you hear? Kenji says, got thrown off a building, some unpaid debt. Taki says, exactly, didn't pay off his pachinko machines, now's our chance. Kenji says, to paint the pavement with our blood? Taki says, no, listen, we can buy those machines at half from Bill the Clown. Kenji says, no way I'd enter biz with him if I were you. Taki says, and I'd get smart if I were you. Plan to jack yourself off to death? Dead-end living with your output? Kenji says, at least you won't push me off a roof. Taki says, stop. I'm not screwing around. We're taking those pachinko machines and setting them up in the block. Then we earn big, the end. There's no way this goes wrong. Kenji says, whatever you say. Right. Jambalaya. I wish I could play these games. Ah! Roach Race. Looks like Atari 2600 type stuff. Walking under a griffin. A fireball. The Chronicles of Titania, Book 1. Doesn't sound familiar. I don't feel like looking through them, I'll just see what that is. You haven't an idea what you're talking about, the green-haired woman snorted and mockingly smiled. I've visited many worlds, each built on a lie. Although this might be the first time I've seen people so stubbornly close their eyes to it. Vizan felt a rage rise inside of him. How dare this woman, an outsider to the utopia of Titania, so harshly criticize a system that has guaranteed the happiness of millions, he thought to himself. If anyone is blind here, it's you, Vizan finally erupted. Titania knows no inequity, no scarcity. For the first time in human history, everyone belongs to the privileged class. The woman smiled softly, with a mischievous twinkle in her amber eyes. Is that so? She asked. And your work at this cannery? Why are you unhappy there? Vizan forced himself to remain calm, and in truth he wasn't sure why the stranger's comments had made him so upset. Perhaps it wasn't the foreigner's fault. She could not comprehend that humankind had finally achieved the ideal society. Her home, as she described it, resembled a primitive world, one long tainted by the stain of feudalism. In a sense, she was like a child, intelligent, yes, but ignorant and self-righteous to a fault. There must be a group within society responsible for this type of work, Vizan explained. Thankfully, due to the advancement of robotics, the means of production have become fully automized and shifted away from our hands. We now serve only in supervisory roles, so to answer your question, no, I'm not unhappy. The robots do my work for me. Wait, you do know what robots are, right? Of course I do. We have something similar, only made from clay and stone. Golems? The lime-haired woman replied, still with a smug tone in her voice. Very well, your world has done away with work done by hand, but if that is the case, does that not mean workers such as yourself have lost their former value? Are you suggesting that there are none who govern your progress from above your standing, who determine your responsibilities? No response. The woman's golden eyes flashed as she laughed at Vizan's confused, flustered silence. My apologies, the stranger's lips curled into an embarrassed smile. Maybe you are an equal member of this corporation? But of what I've seen here, nothing about it matches what you have described. Interesting. It's like a communism type argument. Eurodollars. Oh, we can jack in. Getting closer to that 21,000 for him. I want to jack in. Thank you. No, I'm not jacking in, actually, but you know what I mean. Need your help, uncle. From Taki Kenmochi to Hiro Kenmochi. Uncle, I know I still haven't covered my last loan yet, but I really need your help again. This is the last time, I promise. It's important. I might be in real trouble. From Hiro to Taki, borrow from your father. I am not your piggy bank. From Taki to Hiro, please, uncle, you know we don't talk. From Hiro to Taki, then it's time to start. Implants for cheap, cheap, cheap. Huge savings on discounted second-hand cyberware. Don't miss out. Today's deals, plastic sin skin, pink, hand size, medium. Second gen, used 1 week, only near mint condition. Tech hair, green, shoulder length, luminescent, second gen, moderate use, occasional flickering, faint cigarette smoke smell. Alloy feet, chrome, unpainted, men's size 8, first gen, light rust from lake water exposure. Price reduction due to lack of owner records. Synthetic calf muscle, red, no casing, mint condition, second gen, retrofit capable with older joint models. Items go fast, so buy now. Continue following us for the latest and best deals. I don't think there's anything new here. And can I also look in the other? No. Arcade machine. Pachinko machine. So I can't actually do anything with this. Fevers, super fever time. Cleaning machine. Well, there's a lot of breach things here I could have messed with. I gotta get more into that. Job complete.
That's what it's all about. One less tiger in this town. Appreciate your problem-solving skills, V. Get close.
More like 3 or 4. Nice, I got street cred. So. Alright, I thought it might say some kind of closing wrap-up text type thing. Well, that was interesting. Where are we going now? Not all the way over there yet. Side job? My car is here. Or bike. You okay over there? He's freaking out. Don't bump him. Well, if he's still freaking out because of the Safari, but biking. Okay, so when I go faster, this thing doesn't want to turn. I gotta go slow. Alright, so it looks like straight down and making a left. And then side job. I don't think it's this left. I think it's... it's not that left either. That's a right. Wait, it's telling me... you know, it was a right, wasn't it? I think I need a rest or something. I hear the sounds of gunfire. Oh. If you actually turn, there you go.
Cyberpsycho attack, all confirmed. Even reported to MaxTech. Thing is, nobody's gonna show because Militech shut it right down. You ask me, Psycho's gotta be one of theirs. My Eddies are on Lieutenant Mower. Anyway, Corporal's gonna go straight into treatment. So make very, very sure you keep her in one piece.
Okay, there's that, and then the police after me as well? Trying to park this thing. Okay, so all I know is that a Cyberpsycho attack was reported to MaxTech, but Militech elbowed in and took over, probably because it was one of their own. A woman named Mower, serving in Militech's elite division. Be careful, alright? Locate we're supposed to be taking them down. Warning, Cyberpsycho detected. Militech has locked down the area. Keep away. Isn't these the people we're supposed to be taking out with, like, non-lethal ways? Because I don't have that kind of, weapons on me. Is it gonna fail if I just leave? No, walk, don't walk, walk, don't walk. I think that's what she... the Cyberpsycho's... unless this is a different Cyberpsycho, that doesn't matter. She's doing, like, research on them or something? Or that's, I'm thinking of somebody else. I'm gonna pass on it for now because of that. Catch you later.
See you around.
If I kill him, we'll fail it, I'm sure, so... big in Japan. What's big in Japan? Well, find the package and deliver from A to B. Simple job. Let's do that. I hope we can come back to this and not fail on the cyber psycho. I mean, I'm not prepared because I don't have the ammo. When I failed the other guy, helping him get to the hospital or Ripper Doc, whatever, because I didn't have an actual car, I just have this. Alright, so we're going back that way then. Through there?
Please don't shoot.
I don't want to mess around with these guys right now. Oh god. All right. Trying to get away, you know, but oh,
for real?
No.